What you got on that chain, Perk? You know, oh, there we go.
I mean,
there
you
we
know,
go.
It's just a little picture of the family. Nothing too major. Damn, you know what I mean?
Like, look, I'm looking say, super lame
I'm
today.
I'm going to let my chain hang low.
It's looking good. Guys, we had to dress our best today because we know it is a big night. The Big Three is back. Kyrie Irving returning to action, making his long-awaited return on the road versus the Pacers. The Nets hoping Kyrie can help to stop a three-game skid that now has the Nets second in the East. While Kyrie can only play in away games, look at this. There are 22 of them left on Brooklyn's schedule, with the team holding a league-best 13-3 road record so far this season. Now, the Nets do have a tough stretch coming up on the road, with three of their next five opponents currently being projected as playoff teams in the East. Okay, Perk, let's start with you here because the Nets, they will become favorites in the East now with Kyrie back. So what will another chip mean for Kyrie's legacy?
You know what? It will mean everything. And it will shut a lot of haters up, including myself, all right? I fall in that category as being a Kyrie hater at times, not because of what he does on the court. It's his actions outside of basketball. And so when you look at Kyrie Irving, I think if he comes back, he's telling the world that, hey, I do want to play. Yes, I have issues for us getting vaccinated. We understand that. But I'm here for my brothers. And when you think about Kyrie Irving and what he's already done for the game of basketball, we're talking about one of the guys that probably had the greatest handle of all time, one of the best finishers around the basket. I mean, the guy has the complete package offensively, maybe top five skill, most skilled player ever. So for him to come back and to help the Brooklyn Nets win a championship, it does everything for Kyrie's legacy. It puts him high up there in the rankings for his all-time greats. And you know what else it does? It helps the Brooklyn Nets out, because James Harden is a guy that is not signed back. He's not under contract after this season. And so when you look at what Kyrie could do and what he could help, even if it's on the road, I always said this, Charlie and Swagoo, give me a part-time Kyrie than a no-time Kyrie, because I know on the road you need that superstar power. At home, you have KD and James Harden, so your role players play better at home, so you can win home games and get away with not having Kyrie Irving.
You've been
saying
that.
Yeah, no doubt, Perk. No doubt. I was listening to KD talk about Kyrie getting back, and he was saying we got to support our brother. We're happy to have him back. And obviously, it's a very nuanced conversation that we have about, you know, him coming back to the league and only playing away games. But the bottom line is, hoop was hoop, man. Like, my initial problem with Kyrie was the whole voice for the voiceless thing, because I knew at some point, hoop was hoop. He was going to come back to the game. Mm-hmm. And when you look at this situation now, from both sides, from Kyrie's side, Kyrie wanted hoop. Like, Kyrie does some irrational things. Like, let's just all be honest about that. But at the end of the day, he is convicted in his way of thinking. I respect that. Perk, you know me and you talk about this all the time. If you are what you are, stand on it. Like, that's it. That's it. I might disagree. Yes. I might be critical of it. I might not like – I might actually hate it, the stance that certain – people are taking on individuals. But the bottom line is, my respect comes from you standing on what you saying and what you plan on doing. So when you look at this situation holistically with Kyrie coming back with the Brooklyn Nets, yeah, it helps the Brooklyn Nets. We're talking about one of the top basketball players skill-wise we've ever seen play in the NBA. The rapport, the synergy in basketball takes time. I'm interested to see how long it takes for these guys to get actually in sync in games. Remember, they haven't played a lot together. Like, they all are so super talented that they can score enough to get through the tough times, get through the miscommunications and the things that may come about from not having that time on the court. But outside of that, we looking at the Brooklyn Nets. Look, before the season started, everybody wanted, well, I know I wanted, I wanted to see the Lakers and the Brooklyn Nets play in the NBA Finals. And that was along with Kyrie being in that series. Mm-hmm. Don't look like we're going to get the Lakers there, Perk. But ultimately, when you get Kyrie back with the Brooklyn Nets, who's already playing well, and you look at KD and James Harden, who I think relationship-wise with Kyrie are willing to relent in order to let him get going, because he's been off the court for so long, this team is about to take off, and we all know Kyrie can hoop, and he's going to make the Brooklyn Nets better.
All right, and we have one more joining the debate, Miss Monica McNutt. How you doing today?
Good morning, Charlie. Hey, fellas. Hey, the bust up. The
good morning.
And perk preview. It's a terrific podcast, by the way. I am still waiting for my invitation, but good morning.
Much love, sis.
Monica, okay. I'm actually so really happy.
It's coming.
I'm really happy you're here because for the past week, you and Perk have been on opposite sides of the fence as far as Kyrie is concerned. So the question that we've been talking about is, what will another chip do for Kyrie's legacy? Your thoughts?
Oh, man. All right. So obviously it will add to his legacy. But I have this interesting, slightly interesting theory that this could be in some way a bit of a Pandora's box. And let me just take y'all down this mental rabbit hole for a second. Remember when load management became a thing, a prevalent thing, so much so that Commissioner Silver ended up addressing it, and there was this idea of penalties for guys missing games and so on and so forth. I pray to God that we do not have to repeat pandemic living, but I do wonder that if he's able to get this done as a part-time player, what type of exceptions are we then potentially opening the door to in the conversation of the elite, of the most elite in our league, in terms of what their talent and ability will allow them to do without necessarily the same commitment as everybody else on the roster. Now, I will say in this process, Swagoo, I'm with you. Kyrie has never misled us. I loved the way that he was honest and candid when he spoke to the media in his return, admitting that he wasn't prepared for some of the sacrifices that came with his decision. However, it's kind of like when you make a big-time purchase the first time, right? Like, the first time you got like, and then it becomes a habit, and then you just kind of wonder, you know what I'm saying? Like, will we see some remnants of this very unique year, especially if they're able to be successful?